thina bakahlavana abhula umlilo endulinde obuba somantshonga benoqelemane. Siyakwamukela isiqephini sohlelo lwanamhlanje. Njengoba ke sazi ukuthi siphuma kumandulo, nokuyinyanga lapha uZulu ubungaza ngayo ilembe, isilo sakwadukuza. Esiqephini sanamhlanje, sizokhuluma kabanzi ngelembe. Umlando uyakuveza ukuthi isilo sakwadukuza unodumehlezi kamenzi uyo wabumba uZulu. Ngokomlando isilo sakwadukuza, besinekhono kanye nobuhlakani uma kuziwa kwezempi. Ilembeke laliphinde libe nothando olumangalisayo likanina indlovukazi uNandi waselangeni. Kanti-ke lapha kuseshowe, ikhona-ke kulele khona indlovukazi eyakhotha maqede ilembe lahlukumezeka cisho kwaze kwaba sekugcineni kwempilo yalo. Ilembe kuthiwa lalinesigodlo lapha eshowe kwabulawayo. Ngokomlando, kuvela ukuthi-ke kwakunezindlu ezingaphezu kuka-30,000. Kanti-ke kuthiwa-ke bezifaniswa nedolobha.
Uyindawo amaZulu ayiqhenya kakhulu ngayo ngoba ubukhosi namandla nobuqhawe bukaZulu buqalela ngoba ukufundiswa kwabantu indlela yokuyiphatha izintombi izinsizwa ngokwegaba negaba bekwenziwa khona la kwabulawayo.
Kufanele siwuqonde umlando wethu njengesizwe nezwe laseNingizimu Afrika lulonke. Njengoba namuhla sithi sakha isizwe esibumbene, esingakhethi ngokwebala, sihamba la ilembe elaqale khona ukwakha isizwe esingaxwasani ngokwebala, futhi isizwe esizihloniphayo sona, isizwe esihlonipha amagugu aso nemvelaphi yaso. Uma sithe nyaka enye isifundazwe sethu senza kangcono kwimiphumela kamatikuletsheni kungenxa yakho Silo nesisebenzi oyenzile ukusilekelela ukufukula ezemfundo. Ngoba ezemfundo isona sikhali sokwakha ikusasa lomuntu nomuntu esikhathini sanamuhla. Isilo ilembe lafumba isizwe, kodwa silo samabandla ukhombisile uqhawe ngokwakha isizwe ngemfundo nokuguguzela ukuvikela isizwe ngokuningi okubalwa ukufundisa ukuziphatha. Siqhenya kakhulu ngeqhaza silo samabandla olubambile ephulweni nobhubhane lolu lwe-COVID-19 esibhekene nalo. Sithi siyisizwe sisonke masiziqhenye sibonge kakhulu bonke labo ababesekhaleni lokulwisana nalempi. Sibonile isilo sikhuluma nomhlaba wonke ngomkhosi womhlanga ngendlela okumele senze ngayo ukuzivikela kulesi sifo.
Singakhonzelizwe lethu thina ngeke sikhonze kwendaba yemfezulu. Thina ngeke sikhonze kwasosha kwendaba yezikhali. Uzulu ngeke akhonze kwasosha kwendaba yemfezulu. Thina ngeke sikhonze kwasosha onoma bephela Uthi singakhonza le basa singakhonza izwi lethu uzulungeka khonze kwaso Singakhonza le kwaso awandaba bese uzulungeka khonze kwaso singakhonza lizwe lethu
Mbukeli ake siphinde futhi sibonane ngemuva kwekhefu. Nina bakamphangela ngalingakaphumi kwandoni olutheliphuma laphuma nezingazi zamadoda esigabeni sesibili sohlelo ebukhosini. Nokuwuhlelo-ke lapha sisuke silandela isilo samabandla kanye nendlunkulu yonkana kaZulu. Sikhuluma-ke ngamagalelo ombumbi wesizwe samaZulu. Ilembe. Ingonyama kehleze esihlalweni njengamanje isilo samabandla onke umlomo ongathethi manga. Sethula inkulumo yaso. Sikhulume kanje ngelembe.
Phakathi kwezinto-ke ilembe lasifundisa zona kwaba umqoka wokuba munye phambi kwesitha. Kanjalo nempi yasesandlwane yasifundisa okufanayo. Singalibali futhi ukuthi impi yasesandlwane yaliwa ngamadoda 50 years after isilo sakwaDuza sahamba emhlabeni bayibamba ngoba babesenobunye ilento ke funwa uNkulunkulu esizweni ngesizwe nathi masi sithatha isiqalekiso sokwehlukana siyokwehlukana ngoba sivumele uSathane kufanele uSathane simvumele ukuba sehlukane ngemqondo singehlukana ngokwamaqembu kodwa when it comes to the nation wise let's unite and face the enemy
Ilembe. Lathi ke selisikele amankengane umhlaba ngale kothukela. Laba selakhe isigodlo salo kwaDukuza. Okumanje ke sisebenza njengenkundla yezokuvakasha.
Masifunda umlando siyathola ukuthi ilembe labe liphaka impi ngenxa yemkhankaso ethile neyabe incike ekwakheni noma ekuvikeleni isizwe. Uma sasakwazi ukuyivikela. Ziyosingena izizwe. Zingene ngathi ngoba vele sesiyisitha kithi thina uqobo. Uma ayiphonsa enyakatho, wabe azi ukuthi kuyokwenziwani. Kanjalo nalabo ababeyingxenye yaleyo mikhankaso babazi ukuthi kuyokwenziwani. Ubezwe bethu uyadela wena obulapho ngoba bazi ubumqoka bomkhankaso lowo. Yintina singakubungi okwenziwa yilembe namabutho alo ayekhona ngalezo sikhathi. Nesizwe sasikhona ngalezo sikhathi. Senza izinto ezahlukile. Sinqoye umhlaba kangaka ukuthi siyisizwe esazi ukuthi sabhala umlando. Namhlanje awukhohlakali.
It should be part of tourism. Ngoba uma isilo sakwadla amahlahla kuzeni sikhothama emhlabeni. Ngicela neze umlando nuvuselele nina njengohulumeni wakhona. Umbuso mangiyisrayela bathi silo siyakweleta sikweleta uMr. Glass owayisizwa uZungu ukwakha leyandla bathi kodwa ngo-1933 basebethi siyakweleta njengoba sikweleta nje bazoyithatha lendlu bafake u-High Commissioner of Great Britain kuyona kodwa abantu bakwaZulu ngeso sikhathi babesaphila bathi kubili kuthathu singafanini balwa ngizokuchaza umlando bathi singafanini lapho kulala khona inkosi yethu esigodlweni sayo Ngaleso sikhathi bathi singamane sikhipha 2 and 6. AmaZulu onke akhipha 2 and 6. Leyo mali yazelekelela abantwana benkosi ba bafunde ngayo. Basiqeda leso sikweleti. Empeleni inkosi ayingakweleti. Babefuna ukuyithatha nje lendlu. Ngoba beyibona ingaba yigugu. Ngoba yona ndlokuqala eyakhiwa ngohlobo lwe-Mediterranean style in the north. Ngithi angibeke ndunankulu ngoba izoba ziyifundiso. Laphaya inkosi ucetshwayo yayise-Cape Town kulesi silanga phansi. Lesiya kuleyabhena enkulu. Kunesikhathi kade beyithatha. Beyibambela apha engome. Bahamba nayo. Baye bafika ePort Dunford esikhaleni. Bafika umkhumba wahamba. Sebe phakathi baba bathe bawudumisa wahamba wathula tu. Ukhosi benu insinansina kaNkulunkulu. Abantu bakhala ngamakhosi abo nje bafuna amakhanda awo nje, thina sifuna ikhanda lankosi ngoba inkosi yethu thina onke amakhosi ethu ayiboshiwe abuya. Wathi ngidedeleni ngekhaya bathi sikwehlulile cetshwayo. Sihamba nawe. Wathi hayi angibikile ekhaya angeke kuhambele umkhumbi la. Angeke kuhambe. Bavuma. Bathi zofika ubike phuma sishisile nesigudlo sakho. Wathi ngofike ngime enhla kwesibaya. Ngibike ngisenza i-research nje ukuthi ubani wakhipha imbuzi yokubika. Ngoba sifike lapha eNgilandi sabona bemasha bengenzela i-national salute. Ngeflege lami le bathi bafule lami impela iflege lapha eNgilandi. Lona libhibha lapha ne-Wales nelamangisi kanje. Babemasha nembuzi abathi bayibimbekwa ikhosikhethwa ngamangala nembuzi eneyibo eyinkulu kangaka ngoba sinazo imbuzi enokungaka lapha. Kungumlando ke. Kepha inhlupheko kwakhe umbumbi amakhosi amlandelayo ahlangana nenhlupheko ngoba udingani, inkosi udingani wahlangana nempi yaseNcobe 1838. Kwamangalisa ukuthi babe sebexabanisa sebengena phakathi kwenkosi udingane nenkosi umbane, umntwana udingane nomntwana umbane. Nakhona lapho futhi babona ukuthi mabengene kanjalo bedivide umndeni kuqala bawungena ngcono ezilokozulu bahlikize. Yingakho namanje salwela izwe lethu ngoba umonakalo abawenzayo unikeza i-challenge kwabasendlunkulu ukuthi must come back to the monarch, present monarch. Ngoba uma ngabe bengakwenzi lokho bazohlupheka endlini zabo ukuze kube yinkinga bazo babuye bezela. Ngoba le nkosi ucetshwayo eyathi emkhunjini emangisini ngeke uzuhambe lo mkhumbi ngingayanga ukuyobika kobaba bami ukuthi sengehluliwe sebeyangidatha.
Mbukeli, ake siphinde sibonane futhi ngemuva kwekhefu. Nina bakadlothova kabheke kufana nemsebe yelanga. Siyakubingelela-ke, siyakwamukela uma ungaba usanda kusijoyina ohlelweni ebukhosini. Namhlanje sikhuluma ngamagalelo eLembe, umbumbi wesizwe samaZulu. Lapha-ke kuseshowe, kanti lesi isihlahla samagwala. Kulapha-ke iLembe elalijezisa khona amabutho ayehluleka ukukhusela uZulu uma besempini. Eshowe-ke kuphinde kutholakale inkundla yamacala, lapho ingonyama-ke uShaka eyayihlulela khona. Mbukeli, kuningi esingakubalula malungana neLembe. Kanti-ke leli iliba lengonyama-ke uShaka elitholakala khona kwaDukuza.
Cultures of the Zulu Nation has been living under threatened for years. Because during the time, King Cetshwayo, after the Anglo-Zulu War, you know the history that he was arrested for Castle after they've actually attacked Ulundi in 1879, after the Battle of Isandlwane, 1879, January the 22nd. And then when the British came back on the 4th of July, burning down of Ulundi, as it was the capital city of the Zulu nation, where King Cetshwayo was settled. And then after that, the Zulu nation have scattered. Not scattered from other parts, but they were infiltrated by certain policies and by certain people that instigated them to do away with the king. But it wasn't easy from my people to object King Cetshwayo as their king. That's where the cultures of the Zulu nation started, you know, to move sideways. So now, when it comes to my grandfather, some of my grand uncles, they've never had an opportunity to look back on the cultural values of the Zulu nation. They were not even dressing up in Zulu attire. And then even to my uncles, during my late father's time, King Cyprian, Prince Mangosuthu can support my statement. In 1954, that was the time they started to get things together, to make things work on cultural values with the attire. When the first time for opening of the statue in the tomb of King Shaka. So that's where you could have seen the Zulu people starting to come up with their own traditional attire and the royal family most.
You have revived many of the traditions, the old traditions of that nation. Yet, many of these traditions have been subject of criticism and, in the best case scenario, have been controversial. Why such controversy and criticism for reviving such traditions?
I feel shame and sorry.
Especially the reed dance ceremony and keeping up with the male circumcision.
Well, I feel shame and sorry for those people that have got such a feeling. I'm sorry that it's some of our black people, you know, that have got such things. But as far as that is concerned, I don't think would be having so many people in this country if I've never revived some of the events.
How and why?
Because of HIV and AIDS pandemic. Because if you have heard Prince Mangosuthu Buthelezi last evening of dinner on my birthday, he just mention that His Majesty have actually spoken about HIV and AIDS long before, 2 years before it was discovered. And then our king have prophesied about this disease. So now we appreciate what our king has been doing all these years. Even Dr. Dlomo, the Minister of Health, said the same thing. So when it comes to this criticism, I'm not worried about it because I know when you are doing something good, there are some people that will just keep on criticizing it. But
can you explain to us, sir, how reviving the tradition such as the reed dance ceremony would serve as awareness raising against AIDS?
Culture, it's a unifying factor to any nation. It's just like a religion. If you think of a certain religion, you find unity. Even on cultural values, you find a sign of unity and peace within. So now, I looked at it in a very close eye. When God tells me about this disease coming, and I had to question myself, what am I going to do when such a disease is going to come? Because the disease, it means it's going to be brought by the devil. And I wouldn't do this without my belief.
How did you prophesize that disease before it came into existence, or it was discovered?
Well, if you are close to God, as I believe, that God have brought us the Son, Jesus Christ, and then I need to, you know, when I pray, I've got that, you know, mind of listening and that ear of listening to God telling me something. And then I ask God, why, God, are you telling me this? What must I do to save your people and to save my people that you have just made me to lead them? So you are the one to tell me. And then when I go on praying, waiting for the answer, and the answer came, your culture is the one that can actually bring all the women together. And then you cough it out, the message that I've just given to you.
To keep the virginity until marriage.
Actually, virginity is not important. Virginity is for caring. And then the advice to the people that you could see that they are being weakened by men who cannot protect themselves. So to give them that strength, I thought I should bring the young ones, because I know the devil spirit is targeting the youth in any country in the world. As you could see, the way how the drugs are being scattered everywhere, they're not targeted to myself and you, who are old enough that you can just go for that you can just go for that. But our children, they are living under threat, because there are some people who are just targeting to destroy the future nations of tomorrow.
From what I see in the curricula in South African schools, there is the minimum emphasis on history, namely the Zulu history. Why do you think this thing about the lack of emphasis on history in general and the Zulu history in particular? And do you think something that should be done in that respect?
I don't think we need to worry about the Zulu people only when it comes to this. The problem is sitting in the previous history, which our government at the moment is not bringing the history into practice within our own education institutions. The history that we're still sitting on top of is the history of Jan van Riebeeck. It's not yet actually considered to be brought back into practice in our schools, just to tell the real history and to remind our institutions to give a period of history as it used to be in the past. So now, it is not something that is facing the Zulu nation only. It faces all race groups in this country who will one day will find themselves being in a very difficult position, not to know where they come from. What helps us is that today, I know my history. When I stand before my people, I have to make sure that I remind them.
Mbukeli, kungake besikuphathele kona ohlelweni lanamhlanje akuze kube ngokuzayo.